The ladder over there leads up to the caravanserai. You should be able to hire a ship without too much difficulty. Thank you. Can I ask some other questions?
I think I'm ready to try something new.
Fine. What do you want? Get 100 XP. Milavest is a sanctuary for our kind, supposedly from the Sorrow, but more realistically, it's a sanctuary from the endless fighting. Idiris, she's like the mother of the place, enforces a strict non-violence policy in there. What's the story with you and the other castoffs? She gives you a long, slow look. You were in the mirror. You saw what happened. I wanted to make a difference, and they pissed on my hopes. After that debacle, I killed Tash and fell out with the rest of them. She frowns. The conflict between the First and the Changing Gods swallows all our siblings, one way or another. I didn't want that. I wanted to make my own way. They weren't pleased. And here I am. No worse for the lack of their company. They betrayed me, so I betrayed them. Very few of them trust me now, and good riddance. Who's the First? The First castoff? She was, or she claimed to be. She's dead now. She said she'd fight for all of us. They say she was the one who founded Milavest for our sakes. Most of our siblings remember her as a hero. She spits in the corner. Most of them never actually knew her. She was driven, I'll give her that. Even with her decaying body, with all its hurts and wounds, she found masks to cover herself, and the strength not to hurt, and she kept plowing on. Most of our siblings remember her as a hero who died protecting them from our sire's machinations. Most of them didn't know her like I did. What can you tell me about the Changing God? Brilliant, charming, and ruthlessly self-centered. More blood on his hands than I'll ever have. Legend says he wiped out the Debat. A nearly complete genocide. He left one alive as an object lesson, one of their generals enslaved in the city to teach his enemies not to cross him. Oh yes, he's named the genocide and he's in Circus Minor. Off to the side there. There is no man who cares more about himself. The fact that he keeps his immortality to himself is proof of that. How many castoffs are there, anyway? She shrugs. Hundreds? Who knows? Supposedly the Changing God went to other worlds, bent time and space, slipped through dimensions, and he always had his spare bodies with him. There could be thousands, millions for all I know. What can you tell me about this place? This is the Cave of Last Words. It was a thief's hole until the tunnel leading in collapsed. 500-600 years ago, it was where the scum of the city would slip away from the city guard. Before there were levies, before the slave families, the truly desperate lawbreakers fled here when they had no other options. That there, that's the suicide tunnel, she points. The words on the cave walls, those are the final words of people with nothing left to lose, etched into the bedrock of the city, burned in and burned out by the hopeless. A fitting metaphor. And she thinks, I almost wrote my own words there, many times. Not that diving off a cliff would have ended me. And then there's a ledge at the end of the tunnel, just in case those words are inspirational. Her crooked grin resurfaces. The view is also quite nice. It's an odd thieves hole. Story is that Chilla hid here before she became famous. It was old even then. A place where suicides and the desperate would come to launch their last big score, escaping life on their own terms. How did you find this place? I listened to the stories of old thieves. I went to the Bloom and listened to the stories of Chilla. I made friends with the Stika, and I asked them if they knew about a place like this. Turns out they did. I listened. The rest of her reply is a long, cold stare. Would you travel? I don't know if I want to take her with us. Too many with you already. Don't want to join the menagerie. Maybe after you drop them off. All right. Farewell, Matkina. Good luck. So now we get to look around this place. Underbelly? Caravanserai. And that goes down to that ledge she was talking about that you can drop off of. Maybe we can get to another place. Maybe there's some Numenera there or something. So we have plenty of stuff. The clay containers smell of cheap wine and spoiled food. A dirty wash basin sits atop a barrel of stagnant water. Is this interact? That's interact. Loot?
Ready.
I guess we can just take the stuff from her. 23 shins and a fleetfoot moss, which heals 3 points of speed. We will take the lot.
I'm going.
And 33 shins and a father teller. Huh. This small, polished disc looks like a handheld mirror, but anyone who looks into it sees an image of their father, or their species equivalent, looking back at them, mirroring their every move. When you hold it, though, all you see is your own face. Huh. When we see the changing god, or we're seeing his last face. Interesting. There's nothing more we can do with it. So what's down there? Oh, underbelly. Let's go this way then.
Gladly.
This is that ledge that we saw from Caravanserai. The final words of countless men and women are scrawled upon a stone wall. Some apologize to loved ones, while others rage against an injustice or a slight. A few left only their names.
As you wish.
As you wish. Interact? What, climb down? We've got all these interacts.
Here comes the boredom slayer!
A sheer cliff rises above the ledge. Its surface is rough and jagged. There are enough handholds that it looks climbable, but it wouldn't be easy. What's up there? Yeah, let's try to go up there. And then I guess after that we'll try to go down. Yeah. ...80% success. Stat pool spent on effort restored. The cliff face is deceptive. Holds that look like they'll crumble in your hand stay firm, while solid-looking protrusions crumble like they were made of sand. With careful planning, though, you make it all the way to the top. And where are we? Cool, we're with this thing. A welcome blast of wind caresses your face at the cliff top. Your companions follow the path you blazed for them. Huh.
Absolutely.
We can interact with this thing. Hail, Gibra Merchant. Loot behind it, I guess? What else do we have?
Yes.
That's it. There's nothing else. Most of the cliff top is obscured by a dome of energy. When you get close to it, the air hums and your hair stands on end. Try to see what's inside the dome. The air sizzles as you get closer, popping across your skin like invisible jumping beetles. When you are within an arm's reach, a control interface appears in the air in front of you. It has a glowing circle with strange symbols floating at the edges and a vertical bar next to it. When you step back again, the interface disappears. Whatever energy forms this dome is completely opaque. You can't see anything through it. Oddly, though, you can see the shadows of the cliffs and birds on the other side. Study the interface. I don't suppose this is what we put that code into? 3431? I don't think so. Oh, we're gonna use lore. Oh, we have nothing. Damn it. I need to rest and get intellect back. It looks simple enough. It almost certainly opens the dome, but you can't tell anything else without actually trying it. Try to see inside. No matter how close you get, you can't see anything inside, only the shadows of whatever lies beyond. Touch the dome of energy. Ouch. Huh. The air heats up, dancing across your skin like fire. Ignoring the minor pain, you press two fingers against the surface of the dome. Suddenly, your fingers are stuck fast to the dome's energy. The burning intensifies, and smoke rises from your fingertips. Screaming, you manage to wrench your fingers away from the dome, stumble, and fall to the ground. Well, at least now we can use that hand and people can't, you know, get our fingerprints off things. So blue tide and red tide raise a small amount and we took 4 damage. Callisthenes says, "Oh child, not everything is a door to knowledge." I need to rest and come back. That's what I need to do. Level up. That was quick anyway. Intellect. Okay, intellect and speed. And Tiber. Extra effort is all we have. Yes. Abilities unlocked. Lucky combatant. Plus 15% on attacks. Blindfolded and upside down, you'd still hit your target. You're just that good. Cipher limit increase. Plus 1 cipher limit. Don't really need that. Tall tale teller. All other party members gain plus 5% on lore machinery. Lore mystery, mystical, sorry, and lore natural tasks. Tiber has seen a few things in his life, and he's more than willing to share what he knows. His allies benefit from his experience and eagerness to rehearse his favorite stories. Sounds like him. I don't know. My 5% isn't much. Survivor. Gain 15% evasion. Call it luck or skill, but Tiber is very, very good at staying alive long enough to loot the bodies. I'm going to take, we got between Survivor or Lucky Combatant? I'm gonna choose Lucky Combatant. Can I choose 2? No. Abilities. Resourceful. You know how to handle your ciphers and how to store them properly. Allows you to carry additional ciphers. We got another option for that. Versatile effort. When the flex skill is active, you gain a 5% plus 5% bonus. For each level of effort applied to tasks, it affects. You're a jack of all trades, able to make connections between disparate tasks. Your broad base of knowledge makes it a snap to apply your skills to new situations. And Brawler. Ignore the flanked fellow when surrounded by enemies. You're never surrounded. You're exactly where you're supposed to be. That's pretty cool. I'm going to choose Brawler. Wow, we get a whole bunch of stuff. Then we can choose a skill as well. How about, initiative, so he'll go first in battles. You can only choose one. Okay. We also need to level up Callistige. Increase edge. What does she need? It's too bad I can't move these windows and they block things. An edge in might, because she really has low might. Oh, I can't choose that. Which is less? Speed. Oh, he's almost ready. 10 points and he'll be leveling up. What's his name? Eritus. Oh, and what's my dominant tides now? Gold and blue. It was already gold and blue.
Hyber! Do you have an ending for that story about the annoying glowing man yet?
I wonder who that could be.
Not yet, but I'm optimistic.
I need to... yeah, rest. How do I get back down from here? Oh. The sheer cliff looks more frightening than from above than it did from below. The ledge at the bottom looks minuscule, dwarfed by the immensity of the ocean, which lies 1,000 meters straight down. Jump down? Oh, look at that. We have 666, what do you call it? Money. Shins. We need to go rest. It takes enormous effort not to look down. You manage to scale the cliff one hold at a time. Before you know it, you've reached the edge. Why can't we rest? I don't want to get stuck
going, I am the very soul of action.
Going down. She should let us rest in here, this lady. He has what? Oh, she has. Yeah, the flex skill.
With alacrity.
What does it say? Active until next sleep. This looks like plenty of places to sleep. I'm gonna have the option. Well, we'll go back to Caravanserai. We'll go rest. And then I'm coming back here.
Yes.
Though weathered, the rungs of this ladder are firm and strong. At the top of the ladder, you can see a closed hatch, and can also discern the levers that hold the hatch snugly closed. Can we come? We can come back, right? Hold on, I gotta save. I know this is kind of lame.
Ready.
Yeah, why wouldn't we be able to come back? I wonder if I can go straight there. We're not going to go there yet, right now, though. I'm just going to go rest. So we could explore that stuff and... explore the sphere. And go up and down from the sphere. And see what's down below as well.
Something to do.
Here, sleep. That's what we're going to do. I just want to see if I take this off. It's there. She still has it. Cool. Okay, we are good. Look at that, 16 intelligence. Awesome. Intellect. Okay, so now what I do Let me put that on. You know what? Well, I can't quit out now. Yeah, I can. It's helpful if I know what I need for, right? That's the thing. Yeah. You know what I was gonna do, which is obvious, whenever you wake up, like, just put the effect on, but we don't know what we're gonna need it for during the day. So I'll just keep it nearby for when we really need it, when we fail at a task or something like that. Where's the thing I actually... yeah. Alright, so...
Tiger, that story you were in the middle of, can you just skip to the end and talk backwards?
It ends with the hero having to choose between patience and silence.
Ugh, rather die. I am the very soul of action.
Let's talk to Kosh over here again, see if there's anything new. Philethus. Oh, yeah. The Philethus regards you silently, implacably, still scrutinizing, still seeking. So I can use title search, force it to tell it you about itself. Blue Tide raised a huge amount. Oh crap. A surge of tidal energy pours from you into the Philethus. The creature's bulky armor cloth robes flap and flutter as if caught in a windstorm, and its glass face scintillates wildly, refracting and reflecting the forces brought to bear upon it. A shrill keening, like a kettle brought to boil, blasts to your mind as a fracture spreads across the Philethus' impregnable mask. Uh-oh. What did I do? Then you feel it, a hole inside of you, like something torn away, a truth, an unknown answer to an unknown question, a name, a self. You crumple with the weakness of hollow things and imagine arming yourself in a false enigma, obscuring your shame through obscurity and scrounging through the world's drip for a long, lone lost grain. As you tremble, the Philethus's face goes black and it speaks a short, uninflected phrase. One sees himself in the glass, though it bends. Then the feeling is gone, and so too is the Philethus. What? What the hell happened? Okay, so let's see if I still have any... still have gold and blue. If I'm not careful, blue's gonna become dominant again. I mean, not that that's a bad thing, but...
Absolutely.
How strange, though. I have no idea what's going on with that thing. Maybe we're not supposed to know.
All right.
Now, I wonder if I could just go here. Nope. Can just barely make it out. You can't get there from here.
At last.
What's this? Oh, the Cave of Lost Words. We can just go right from here. Awesome.
Yes.
I was afraid I'd have to take the Stika automaton again. That's right, we did come up from the ladder. Alright.
Of course.
But of course. I'm gonna mess with the sphere thing.
On it.
Thank you. Well, that... with the Philethus, that didn't work. We didn't get an answer to our question. And now the thing is gone, maybe never to return. Retry cost one speed, huh? Try to climb the cliff again. Success!
This is done.
For some reason I want to stand over here to do that. Alright, intellect, lore, mystical. Study the interface again. Success! The circle is likely a place to put one's hand or face, probably the former, since the heat from the dome might burn your face. Presumably, someone with the proper authority could open the dome by using the holographic bar on the side as a kind of latch. The symbols around the circle are unfamiliar, suggesting this installation is very old, perhaps predating the truth. Whoever created this dome, then, wanted to keep what was inside a secret from anyone except those to whom he or she had given access. Try to use the interface to open the dome. As you place your hand in the circle, the symbols light up and spin rapidly. Apparently, you have the authority to enter. Oh, goody. You slide your other hand up the bar on the side. The interface disappears. The air cools immediately, and the dome fades until it is gone entirely. Whoa. Cool. There's stuff in there. Nice. I'm excited now. Ooh. Alright, let's go loot this thing. And then there's these two things. 55 shins. And eyes of the finite. And a war mask. Ooh. Ornament. Sucker punch. Attack that deals weapon damage +3. This is a small glass plate fashioned into a pin, so it can hardly be called a fashion item, as a crowd of otherworldly eyes competes to look out through the glass into the curious world that you inhabit. The eyes reveal weaknesses in foes, especially those already weakened. So if the target has a negative fettle, confer dazed for one round, which is -15% willpower, and on attacks. So if they're already weakened, that's what that does. And we have a war mask. This dark mask appears to be made of wood, yet it feels like cold metal to the touch. When you put it to your face, you hear the sound of war drums beating in the distance. Bump, 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 bump. My mystical lore tells me the mask's face is very similar to that of the mechanical men known as the Orgolian soldiers, who patrol isolated areas of the Ninth World. Their motives are entirely unpredictable, and they are generally viewed as a threat by those who live in the beyond. Some believe that Orgolian soldiers are following orders that are millions of years old, and a few tribes in the beyond venerate the creatures as servants of long-dead gods. Well, we're gonna take all that stuff. Look and see if there's any options with these. We can equip it. This will give it to somebody. This we can't do anything with, apparently. She has an ornament. Conduit rings. Tiber doesn't have one. What is he? With Tiber, I like to use the sucker punch to begin with. Is that going to add to his sucker punch? Grants sucker punch. Okay, it grants sucker punch, and he already has it, so let's give it to Aretas. There you go. Enjoy.